Well, hello. I'm actually not here, but here to greet you this morning, or it might be afternoon. I'm not sure what time you're meeting, but I wanted to just kick off this lesson and to highlight the objectives and habits of mind that I want you to focus on. So we can see here in the SMART lesson that today what you guys are going to do is you're going to look at two conditions for similarity. In other words, how do we prove two polygons are similar? Well, today you're going to talk about two of them. One of them is the angle-angle condition, and the other is called the side-angle-side. Now, as you're doing this, I would like you to focus on certain habits of mind. And the habits of mind today is you're going to be using your technology, your technological tools, to strategically wonder and conjecture about these conditions, okay? So you are going to be led through the lesson. I want you to use your technology wisely and stay focused and be able to come together with me again at the end of the lesson when we'll debrief on what you learned today. Well, I hope you were able to get through the problems that you needed to and that they made sense to you. And right now we're going to summarize what you have learned in class today. So would you please take out your math binders and open it to your math notes section, the toolkit. If you need to pause a minute, pause the video for a minute so you can get situated, please do so. Great. So now you're ready to begin. So now the new math notes, would you please title it Conditions for Triangle Similarity and put the lesson number in the margin. It's 3.2.1. Put today's date also. Conditions for triangle similarity. So we are going to summarize two of the conditions that you have learned. Now, first of all, let us make clear what does it mean for two triangles to be similar. When two figures are similar, the corresponding angles, so you should be writing this down neatly in your math notes, the corresponding angles must have equal measure. And corresponding sides must be proportional. And we have been seeing that in our investigations over the last week. Now, one other thing I want to remind you of is when two figures are similar, there is a similarity transformation or transformations that takes one onto the other. So one way visually to show that two figures are similar is that you can either do a translation, reflection, rotation, or a dilation and take one figure onto the other and create a congruent polygon. Okay, so that is another way to visually show that two figures are similar. Now, let's talk about our conditions. And the first condition that you looked at was angle-angle. Well, question for you. So when two pairs of corresponding angles have equal measure, the two triangles must be similar. Well, why don't you have to show that all angles have equal measure? Well, the reason being is because the third pair of angles must also be equal by the triangle-angle sum theorem. Because we can see here, we have an example of two triangles where two angles are marked as congruent. Well, we know that the sum of triangle ABC will equal 180. Degrees, and the sum of triangle DEF also will equal 180, and if two of the angles are congruent, then that third angle also must be congruent. So if we have two angles congruent, two pairs of angles congruent, then the third pair of angles must also be congruent, and we don't have to prove that every time. So I'm trying to move on to the next slide. There we go. So a couple of ways to look at this idea of angle-angle similarity and to prove that angle-angle similarity is true for a pair of triangles is we can have two triangles. Let's say, go back to my pointer, please. Is it going back yet? Not yet. There we go. I think I've got it. So let's say I have these two triangles here, okay? And they look like this. Now, let's say I want to show that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Well, we do have marked that two corresponding angles are congruent. So then I could say, yes, they are similar by the AA condition. Well, one other way to show it is to use rigid transformations. So for example, I can see if I do a translation, and then if I do a rotation to align them so that the orientation is the same. And then if I did a dilation, we could see then that actually these two triangles are the same triangle by a series of transformations. Now, something else we can notice too then, we can see that we've got a couple of corresponding angles here. Okay, now corresponding angles, if this line is parallel to this line. And we know that if corresponding angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. Okay, and by doing so, then we can see, oh yeah, this angle is congruent to this angle. And we can use all of our knowledge of parallel lines to show the other angles congruent. Okay. So, the second condition that you talked about today was side angle side. So, make sure you put this into your math notes. Whoa, how did that do that? You guys saw, I did not touch it. There we go. Side angle side triangle similarity. Now, the important part about this condition for similarity is that the order matters. It has to be, I have a side KA with an angle between the other side. And basically we are saying if there is an angle that is congruent, and then the sides on either side of that angle must be proportional. So in other words, the ratio between KA over A must be equivalent to the ratio of KB over B. And if this condition is met, then I do know that these two triangles are similar. So we have ratio of corresponding sides, KA to A, an angle between, congruent, and then the ratio of KB to B, side angle side. And again, I could show their similarity by doing a sequence of transformations. So I hope you got all of this summarized into your lesson, and I will see you again next time.